Hi, Mayor Warren. I'm in the office of the city attorney, Gras Montalis. The coronavirus is escalating. We are continuing to get information from both the federal, state, and the county levels about our level of emergency. I'm being advised now that we have come to a point where we need to declare a state of emergency within the city of Orange Township. I understand it's already been declared on the federal level, state level, and the county level. Gras, if you would, just walk us through what this process is and what we're doing here today on your advice that we should move to an executive order declaring a state of emergency.
Sure, Mayor. So we're doing this to allow you to issue additional emergency orders as you see fit, as well as implementing public protective measures throughout the city. We're also doing it to raise public awareness of the pandemic that has certainly affected the entire state and has also affected major cities, including our own. We're doing it in a way to be prepared in the event that we have to implement certain directives in accordance with our state and government officials with respect to sheltering people in designated areas of buildings, as well as large-scale closing of roads, of various roads within the city. This is, given the way that this pandemic is headed, it would give us an opportunity to add more emergency personnel to assist us in handling this pandemic.
And that will affect, I have Elvin Padilla here from OEM. Is there a need for added personnel to our OEM staff?
Absolutely. We are taking measures to expand our OEM division. We held a briefing this morning. We have discussed assignments for outside individuals, runners, staffing. Absolutely a need. As it gets bigger, responsibilities, documentations get bigger.
And where are you drawing the personnel from? Are they from the law enforcement sector already?
We mentioned the other day in your last video that it's all hands on deck. So if anyone's available, doesn't have to be public safety, we will review and check what your expertise, area of expertise, and we will place you appropriately.
Thank you. So, Gras, in drafting this document, what background or what timelines are we looking at in terms of us declaring at this point?
Sure, and the document is in its early stages, as you indicated, Mayor.
This is the draft that you've given me, correct?
Correct. That's being reviewed in preparation for your signature. But the timeline is as follows, Mayor. So on January 30th of this year, the World Health Organization designated the novel coronavirus disease as an outbreak, as a public health emergency of international concern. The day after that, on January 31st of 2020, the United States Health and Human Services Secretary declared a public health emergency for the United States. On March 9th of 2020, the governor of the state of New Jersey, Phil Murphy, declared a public health emergency and a state of emergency by way of executive order.
That was executive order 103.
Correct. On March 11th of 2020, the World Health Organization characterized COVID-19, which is the coronavirus disease, COVID-19, as in fact a pandemic. On March 15th, a few days ago, March 15th of 2020, the city of Orange Township actually confirmed our first case of COVID-19. So obviously the pandemic continues to have a significant impact on our municipal government, as well as various other municipal governments, neighboring municipalities, and the local economy, impacting retail, restaurants, and other industries. And that has resulted in a reduction of work hours, possible layoffs, and clearly a loss of income. So that's why in drafting this directive and this executive order for your review and signature, Mayor, we felt it appropriate and necessary at this time to allow us to, again, fight this pandemic that is plaguing our city.
Will this executive order also deal with some people may have water bills, tax bills, and other obligations that the city do? Will this executive order deal with that in terms of staving off any payment requirements, no penalties, no interest, and that kind of policy decision?
Yes. So one of the things that we're looking to do with respect to this executive order is to extend a grace period for the non-payment of various obligations for our city residents, including water, sewer, solid waste collection, tax collection charges. Again, these are charges that are financially impacting our residents during this pandemic crisis.
And but this does not affect services that we're rendering to the public.
It will definitely not affect the services. The services will continue at its highest form, just allowing the residents to, in fact, not incur the economic impact that is certainly prevalent at this time, given this pandemic.
And OEM Director Padilla, you've given input into this process. Is everything that you think is necessary in the document?
Absolutely, Mayor. Absolutely. We're ready to move forward.
Okay. All right, so I'm going to ask that you continue to draft, finalize it. For my review, I would like to sit with all of the department heads that will be affected to make sure that we have a comprehensive document and then we'll move forward with it.
Understood.
This is a briefing from the law department in the city of Orange Township, and it basically is a process where enables the mayor as the chief executive officer of the city to take measures that will protect health, safety, and welfare, and to make sure that we have a fully staffed Office of Emergency Management so that we could deal with the impending crisis. We still have one confirmed case. There are others, I believe about six others, that are being tested. The public health officer is involved in this process as well. Once we sign it off, it will be put on the city's website, and copies to be read will make it available as well. I would ask that my phone number, in case you need to contact me, 973-373-0025, be placed on the screen should you have any questions. Any information that develops as a result of me signing the executive order will also be posted. So please stay tuned, and if you have any questions, please give me a call. God bless. Stay safe. Now, in connection with the executive order, I understand this also is going to cover hair salons, barbershops, braiding shops, and nail shops as well. What's the effect going to be there?
Yes, Mayor. So it will cover those establishments as well. And what we want to do is, number one, we want to make sure that we continue to adhere to the directives that have been handed down by the state officials with respect to how many people can be in an establishment at one time, as well as the distance that needs to be kept between individuals who are, in fact, in the same area. So we want to make sure that we address those concerns. Obviously, those are the establishments that will continue to service individuals throughout the city, but we want to make sure that, again, they are operating under the guidelines that have been issued by the Office of Governor.
And you've made these recommendations in consultation with the public health official?
I have.
So I understand that there'll be no more than 10 people, including the staff, in the shop at one time, that the shops must be closed 8 p.m. nightly. Employees who feel ill should remain home. All stations and other contact points for customers and employees should be disinfected, and that there should be cleaning and disinfecting of the shops on a daily basis.
Absolutely.
That's fine. So this will be as part of the executive order that's being prepared and drafted for finalization.
Correct.
Now that based on that there's been some change as to the hours of operations for hair salons, barbershops, and nail salons, will that be part of the executive order?
It will be part of the executive order, Mayor. We're actually trying to confirm right now with the governor's office with respect to those changes. We understand that there will be a permanent closure of those establishments as of this evening. But we're in communication with the Office of the Governor to make sure that we have that confirmation.